2.
Woo!
Johnny 5 is alive!
We live.
Terrified of Johnny 5.
I'm more terrified of Johnny Longsword.
Oh man, Johnny Longsword is a legend.
The man.
Watch out if he's in the party. Oh, and then freaking, there we go, okay. And then Drive just like, Alright, bring all this stuff up. Got a couple things to go over before we get to reveling in your
Why sadness. Do you have to bring that up again? Why do you have stuff? To bring up the other night,
no,
okay?
Just chill.
It's not like it's important to the plot or anything.
Everybody now has their own little notepad. So, all you have to do, it's in your handouts, is simply check it out. It just says your character's name and then notes. You can hit edit and add important notes to that anytime you want. This is what I was talking about at the end of the last session.
Okay. Ah! It got rid of all my other windows!
Because you shook it. Just shake it again. Okay. Anyways. On top of that...
DM is a poopy face for killing my groupies.
We have leveled up to level 1. If you will bring up your player's handbook.
Wait, because I need to fix this. I don't like that. Okay. Player's handbook.
Yep, bring up your player's handbook. There is a new section there. And I'll be adding basically before the start of each week or after the end of the session. I'll add any new characters that are there or any known non-personal NPCs.
Awesome.
Granted, Bori is a personal NPC. She's also kind of part of the group at the moment. So I had to add her in there.
I like that brash heart. Yeah.
Shit. Yep, she's still a surviving member of SHIT. The information team.
The shit hit the fan.
No. I went down. Shit went down.
Shit was squished.
Shit went down. That's what happened. Anyways. That's basically all that's been added for this week. We now have access to a thing called Hero Points, if you want to pull that up, if you're not quite sure what it is. Essentially, whenever a character levels up, you're going to lose any Hero Points that you have unspent. And you gain a total of 5 plus half your level rounded down. So you guys have 5 Hero Points. You can spend a Hero Point whenever you make an attack roll, ability check, or saving throw.
Okay, where is that? Oh, Hero Points.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And what happens is you can spend it after you've made the roll, but before I reveal the results. So if you go, I don't think that's going to be enough, you can add your hero point to it. When you add a hero point, you roll 1d6. And that adds the result to that 20-sided roll.
Like if you're hanging off of a cliff and you roll a 10, you might want to use a hero point.
Nah, I don't think that's enough.
But, and then a hero point would make that into an 11.
No, it could make it into all the way up to a 16. You spend
1d6.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Yep. And... yeah, possibly turns a failure into a success.
Mm-hmm.
You can only spend 1 hero point per roll that you've made.
Okay.
Mm. So you can't, I'm going to use all 5 hero points just to be safe. In addition, whenever you fail a death saving throw, you can turn a failed one into a success without having to roll anything. So basically, if you roll less than 10 when you're dying, you can just say, I'm going to go ahead and spend that hero point and make it a success so you don't have to worry about it.
Okay.
I think that's the only changes on that side of the field. For the people that are following on YouTube and Twitch, by the way, guys, subscribe, all that jazz. I'm also going to link you to our Facebook page. And if you like there, you'll be able to check out any articles and stuff that I write. It's just facebook.com/vexedgm. But I'll put it in the chat. And a link below. Anyways, when I move things, everything goes out of place. There we go. All right. So, Sybil is now level 1 bard. She got a couple spells. That's basically the only difference there. Aesir's a level 1 fighter now. He got access to his second wind. He's a great weapon fighter. And Fia is a level 1 wild sorcerer. She gained, how many spells? 2?
2, yeah.
She gained 2 new spells. some other things. I'm moving through this real quick.
Ah.
I had to move through it.
Okay.
And just remind everybody that you do have inspiration after last week's events.
Okay.
Which is already on your character sheet. So I'm going to get out of the character handout. There we go. And reel it on in, guys. We're just reel this back on in.
No,
you're,
I don't want to go on the field trip again.
Still reeling in the loss of loved ones. As the Titanus beast is attacking the city, there's so much going on. Only the day before, you guys were celebrating and being merry, drinking and listening to the tune of Zibble's lute. And it all changed earlier this morning when a thick mist rolled through the city. You now find yourselves surging with anger, sorrow, and in need of justice. Let's pull you guys right on over to Dunnev University. As you sit here in the entrance, a large barrier surrounding the university. Piles of rubble and debris are on the ground. Back on the Academy Towers, there's smaller barriers that seem tighter knit that basically surround the tops of these towers.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah. And you can kind of see that there's a focal point kind of that funnels down into the center of those towers. And those also seem to assist this larger barrier in forming. As you're kind of, Aesir, as you're looking down at and just like grimacing, kind of taking everything in, you see Bori kind of just like clenching her two war hammers, just like gritting her teeth, a tear streaming down her face as she looks out. And you had just seen several professors go in to the portal, supposedly looking for the dean of the school. Just after they walk through, several small beasts rush out. About three or four, and they look very cat-like and kind of clamor over each other and rush in. And then in confusion, they look around before they start darting towards you guys. When that happens, it looks like a couple of other professors kind of jump out in front and add to the barrier. And the beasts crash into the barrier before kind of scattering out into the city. As the rest of you kind of look around, there's this large crack of thunder heard that's coming from overhead. And as you look at where this noise came from, you see this arc of lightning kind of fading, and a wasp about the size of two or three people fall from the sky. As you look to the source of it, you see that there is it came from a halberd being held by a knight on the back of a griffin. The griffin's gold furred and feathered, and has a splotch of black raven-colored feathers along the crest of its head. It turns out that there's five griffins flying in kind of a V formation. One leads the charge, and then it's followed by the four of the knights. The one that's in the front kind of has this like cloak going on.
Are these good guys?
You kind of take in the scenes, and you see that there's several more small squadrons now, kind of formed up, and they're taking shots. Some are actually going off in the distance, and they start arcing this lightning towards the Tarrasque, while others try and take down other air threats, which is mostly like, it's almost like a nest of wasps has just been kind of unleashed in the air of the city. And occasionally you'll see one like dive down and come back up, like it has a person in its little graspers and somebody impaled from its stinger. As this all kind of soaks in, you look back to the entrance of the, move you guys back just a little bit. You look back to the entrance of the university here, and you see the same squadron that was just up ahead now kind of turning around and landing in front of you. And tokens here.
Token, who's got the token? Yeah.
It's one of the griffins.
That's awesome.
Majestic beast.
Yeah. Off the first griffin, which is the one that you see right there, a guy in the cloak steps off the back and begins to address the professors, namely this one right here. And I have too many tapped open. There we go. Fia and Zippel recognize this professor as Professor Town. First name is Lane. She teaches several classes, mostly in magical elixirs and herbs. He addresses her and several other professors and basically just wants reports. He asks for a report on what's going on, what the losses are, what's happening here at the university. He's not really interested in, what's the cause of this, obviously, the gate. Let's see. But before she really has a chance to answer, another wave of cats, basically, and hornets comes rushing through. The high mage kind of looks over and, Token of the Knights here. And the knights that are on the back of their griffins, these are the knights right here, kind of bolt forward and begin to kind of hold their ground as these beasts swarm through. The high mage shouts to clear the square that's out in front of the university, and the professor shouts out to protect the barrier mages, which are located further back here, and there's a couple of barrier mages out in front of you, so they're mostly worried about them and keeping these beasts out, but there's about half a dozen or so cat-like beasts that are just rushing towards the gate. Sorry, the barrier. So let me pull the griffin off here. What I'm going to do is shrink this one here, and we use two tokens that are the same kind of thing. Come here. There we go. It's a barrier mage here. And the high mages kind of rush out in front as these guys kind of fall back just a little bit, because this is a greater number than what they can normally seem to hold off. And the beast and the knight kind of clash very quickly, and the combat's over in just a couple of seconds. The beasts were kind of no match for them, but that's not what really bothered them. The hornets overhead almost slipped through the purple barrier. And then you find that the two barrier mages down below are struggling, kind of sweating, grimacing, and putting all their power into this barrier as the hornets kind of they land against this soft wall of magic and start hitting their stingers and stuff, and they're struggling pretty badly. And this one right here, he falls to his knees, but is holding the barrier. Let me mark him with that little deal right there. And from there, I'm going to ask what you guys want to do.
I think I'd rather the beholder from the last campaign that we had running loose in the city than this.
I'm still low in health, aren't I? So there's not much I can really do, especially against flying things. I guess I can ask Bori if there's somewhere safe we can hunker down in, let these magical people deal with it.
Are you still low on health, or did we get our health back when we...
Everybody got their health back from that surge of power that they felt.
Yeah, yeah. But, we can't take out air units. I mean, we can try to help with the cats that are trying to get in. Well,
let me reiterate that. The barrier mage in front of you kind of like is struggling, fell to his knees. He doesn't look like he's doing... neither one of them look like he's doing too good.
Yeah, so...
Can we hold up our hands and say we'll give you our energy for the spirit bomb?
I give you my life.
Can we do something like that?
Yeah.
Like a moment of anime team help where we put our hands on him and like, yeah, take our energy, bro. You're gonna need it.
What you can do is if you pull up your cheat sheet, your player cheat sheet, it says, one of your actions is to help,
mm-hmm.
and you give another creature advantage on an attack or ability check. So you can totally spend your turn just trying to help them, whether that be holding, like helping him brace himself, you know, what basically whatever. What it is you're going to help them maintain their concentration. Mm-hmm. Right now, their concentration is suffering, and their will is failing them.
In that case, we go and help.
Yeah, yeah. I want to help. I definitely want to help.
I don't like mages, but if it's going to keep us alive as okay. well.
So only one person can help give advantage, because after that point in time, that's, you know, advantage is advantage. It doesn't stack. So Seer's going to help this person.
Okay.
And Bori's actually going to go help this person over here.
Oh, that leaves
you two spellcasters to assist as you wish.
Now, could they help me maintain my concentration while I'm helping them?
No, you get.
I have a help.
You don't have to make a roll to help him.
Yeah.
Let me see.
Is there You said they have cats, like cat beasts, trying to get in as well, right?
Yeah.
And they're pretty much like right on the other side of these guys?
Well, those have been taken care of by the Night Guard and the High Mage. They kind of just like swatted them into nothing. It was
then
a big deal.
I'll try to help this guy.
That's Professor Talon. That's she.
She. I'll try to help this chick.
Yep. And what are you going to help her do? You're just going to try and give her aid, basically?
Yeah. Any way that I can, pretty much, just because I don't know what's going on.
That's fine. Zippo, what would you like to do?
Is there anything, like, let's see. So the wasps are trying to get in through the top, and the mages are trying to hold the barrier up, and the cats were defeated, so... Is there anything like outside, or like is there anything?
Well, you got the wasps that are overhead. That are trying to like just sting through this barrier. I believe one thing that you can do aside from aiding is you actually have Bardic Inspiration that you can use.
Yeah,
as a bonus
action. Can I like raise people's morale somehow with my bard?
Yep.
Like, we're
so
giving them advantage,
so
you'll give them bonuses.
Yeah, you give them basically an extra 1d6. So you can choose one of these guys to, or one of the two guys or the girl there, to get a 1d6. But that you also have extra time during your turn, because that just uses basically your extra action.
So you can, like, take a look around and assess what's going on right now if you wanted to.
Yeah, I kind of...
You can totally,
you
can make a perception check and whatnot.
Yeah, I'll do a perception check to just, you know, kind of get a grasp on what's happening around us, and then also just try to raise morale with Bardic
Inspiration. Okay, so give me a perception check first, then.
Okay, perception check.
All right. So as you kind of take in everything, and you see this fight that's kind of happening in the air, you start to, the screams are what starts to get to you, as you can hear shouts and everything throughout the city. Echoing as the town is literally crumbling in the wake of a Tarrasque. You kind of pull your focus in a little bit more narrow and pull it in on those that are before you, and you look over to the person on the right, and you actually recognize him as a higher up in school. You've never had a class with him or anything like that, but you've seen him around, and you know him at least by name.
This is not what I need right now, Dove.
Oh, wow. Anyways, you recognize him as Brigham, and he's kind of known just for his general combat skills, like whenever they have tournaments and stuff in the school. He's normally one of the top placers. But you've never seen him like this. Normally he's kind of like brash, arrogant, and like full of himself. But now he's grimacing. He's got bags under his eyes. Kind of like sweat pouring down his forehead. Pull it up so you can see him quite a bit better there. He clearly is doing the worst out of all of them. So you give him your bardic inspiration. He's the one that clearly needs it. And he kind of looks back and just... Rather than give a thanks or anything like that, he just gives a snarky kind of, like, nod, like, yeah, that's what you're supposed to do.
A for effort.
I was testing you.
Yeah, you passed.
Well, he's not a professor. He's just a higher up, like a higher up classmate.
Senpai.
Yeah. Mm. And
he noticed you.
Oh, I don't think he did.
Bring that back down.
Man.
That is when you notice, like, this low. And slowly, a massive dark splotch begins to hover out of the gate. And you see this large, bulbous head and some pincers, and then patterns of red and orange and black come through, and finally, like, you see thorax of this thing and several wings, and finally this massive, massive stinger that's attached to this huge thorax, and
what?
It just kind of, like, it's hovering in through and slowly coming at the gate, and that's when the knights and the high mage just start slinging lightning at it and everything, and it just doesn't seem to be hardly doing anything. It's just, like, singes and stuff coming off. It just seems to be getting more and more pissed as it slowly hovers forward. And the barrier mages and the professor are just kind of like, shit. And as it slowly approaches, I need you guys to roll initiative.
I was going to say, can I do a knowledge check on it?
No.
I hate doing initiatives. Why do do we have to?
Can you just say I'm first in the turn order? Because
I know.
Just because.
Oh, thanks. I got a 7.
20.
Damn,
21. I wish I got that.
Your numbers just got mixed up. Just reorganize them.
Yeah, on my screen, that mine was a 21. Just so you know.
Yeah.
Might want to fix that. The system's broken.
Oh my gosh. What are we gonna do, guys? We got things here. And if this barrier breaks, though, like, the school is screwed anyway.
Like, yeah. Turask was bad, but a guy, flying Leviathan stinging bee, not good.
How big is it? Is it, it's like the size of a building, or? Because it's obviously like.
Oh, yeah. Team.
Is it so kind of like the thing in Avengers?
It's kind of like.
It's like a queen wasp.
Oh god.
It's about 25 feet tall, like hovering forward, probably about 15 feet wide.
Ooh,
put the Pacific Rim music on.
Who has the raid? You're gonna need like 60 cans of it.
I got some of this stuff. This should do it.
There you go.
All right.
Just spray it all over yourself and sacrifice. Zibble.
It's your turn first.
Yeah. All right, let me see.
Everyone rolled double digits.
Except for you.
Except for me. I'm like, why am I kind of in the front?
Okay, so. Since this thing's definitely gonna attack us, I want to use my Vicious Mockery cantrip on it.
Okay.
Which is
let's see here. Vicious Mockery. Just need to see what the
Sorry, Kat, if you need inspiration, I got some garlic salt.
Bring back here. I'm trying to see what your save is on it. So the save is 13. Okay. Alright, you saved.
It's saved?
Yeah, so you just, you cast a spell, and it's like nothing. It's almost as if the distance is too great, even though you know you got it in your target.
Yeah.
Ooh, what about the whispers thing?
Oh.
I don't think I can do that because
not until our next turn. You wish to move anywhere.
Come on, boy, I believe in you.
Its next attack is what I was going for, but...
Okay. Bori
is going to hammer throw one of her hammers and kill it.
Bori rushes over to you, Azir, and she helps. So you have advantage on your next attack, or whatever swing rate you make. The five knights and the high mage, the four knights, blast this thing with more eldritch magic, and it finally seems to be boring into the carapace of this large wasp.
Okay.
The high mage chants something. It's clearly to usable. It's clearly just babble, basically. But it's what he's doing with that babble that's important. You can almost feel the enchantments being weaved into his speech and getting laced with some familiar magic. It seems like it's enchantment magic. Now, normally I'll have you make a detect magic, but this is just kind of helping prepare for the future whenever you do have detect magic. Anyways, he casts a spell, and the beast kind of begins to wobble and act confused and starts to kind of veer away from the barrier. It's here.
Mm-hmm. So the Eldritch Knights, are they on the griffins flying around?
What's that?
Are the Eldritch Knights on the griffins flying around?
Not at the moment. Nah. They're on the backs of the griffin because basically if they were to go in the air, the other hornets would probably come down at them.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I think I'll keep helping the barrier guy.
Okay.
And can I also, as my bonus action, tell Bori to go back to helping the other barrier dude?
Oh no, that's an action to you to help. It's a full action. You can ban people. Oh wait, just saying. I already got them, but. Anyways. Sam. Oh, so, yeah, it's an actual action. Grab that turn order because I don't have a token for it. Anyways, it goes right here. The wasp, we continue to fight and sting, and you can see the mages kind of struggling against the pressure on the barriers. And the large wasp kind of veers back around, and rather than before, where it was just kind of like slowly hovering, it kind of speeds up and crashes into the barrier.
Oh no!
Oh,
the it hits with such an impact that the ground kind of rumbles a little bit, and you can see the barrier kind of just start to give in. Not only does it kind of fall back like it's really tough rubber, it begins to crack.
Oh
and
no!
You
prepare to fire the ion cannon.
You can see the mage is struggling with it, but Brigand seems to be struggling the worst as a small nosebleed begins to form.
Oh god.
He struggles and grimaces, but the barrier holds just barely, even though the cracks are showing. The wasp begins to kind of like slide down the barrier now, that just due to its own weight. Yeah, it's just like zzz, zzz, zzz. And Fia, it is your turn.
Kill it, Fia. Kill it. Do it.
Can I?
You can do it. You can kill it.
You're the best.
No. Not with this 5 HP. No, thank you.
That fit with something.
Well, it's way too big. I doubt that I'll even be able to do anything. I can try.
Exactly, Kev.
You'll try.
Okay.
Do.
Let's try. How far away is it from us, roughly?
About 30 feet. It's literally right there.
Okay. Oh, God.
The barrier above you. I should say it's between 30 and 60 feet. Gonna have to be abstract here.
How far is it off the ground now?
Probably 20 feet off the ground.
Damn it.
Crap. Well, I can't even. Will my 30 foot range hit it? I don't think so. If it's between 30 and 60 and 20.
Let's do it.
Okay. Let's try it. I'll go ahead. I'm not moving from behind anybody because I need some shielding.
Meat shields.
But yeah, I need some meat shields. Shit, I can't do this. I didn't buy components.
Or you didn't pick them up before we left the bar.
No, because I didn't have a spell. So I can't use that one. Oh man, I can't use my level one spells.
Yeah, I'm really regretting not writing that magic
any
spell
of
there.
Them.
What's that?
I can't use any level one spells.
You're done.
Can I do a knowledge check on it to see if...
Yes, nature.
Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Boop.
Nice.
Ooh.
So you've seen wasp nests, things like that, especially back where you're from.
Mm-hmm.
You've seen queen wasps.
Mm-hmm.
There's good news and bad news.
Mm-hmm. This isn't a queen wasp?
Good news is this isn't a queen wasp. Bad news is this isn't the queen.
Oh god. Is this a soldier wasp?
This seems to be like some sort of warrior wasp. While the others were just little workers.
Oh man.
That is your turn. By the way, those of you that are normally playing 5th edition and stuff like that, this is not in the monster manual.
Oh, God.
Climb onto a bigger creature. you know what? I'm just going to climb on a seer and hide. No, I think...
Don't pull onto the beard. The beard's sensitive.
I need to back up.
Okay.
And, I'll help out this guy before I do.
Okay.
I'll pat him on the head. It's okay. I'll wipe the blood from his nose.
Okay.
Give him some words of inspiration. It's okay. You're not going to die right now.
If you fail this, we're all going to die.
Yeah. If you burn, so do we.
I don't know exactly feel like being impaled by a wasp.
Mm-hmm.
So, much to your dismay, the shields continue to crack. Then there's a blur of yellow and a flash of silver. And it happens so fast that you see something go, what looks to be behind this large wasp. And then the sound hits. I need everybody to make a wisdom save. A constitution save.
Wait, if it's checked, do I have advantage?
No, it just gives you plus two.
Okay, here we go.
Constitution?
Okay.
Hero point.
Mine's not gonna help. Oh my gosh.
Okay.
Wait, can I use inspiration for it? I have 1 point of inspiration.
Yes, but your result would be a 7.
Really?
Yeah,
it just gives 2 points? Oh, because it just takes advantage. Okay.
And so the hero point, yeah, can I use the hero point with the 11?
If you would like to.
Yes, I would love to.
Okay.
Roll a d6. Look at Louis' face! Oh my god.
Are you kidding me?
Oh my god!
One hero point down, four to go. All right, is everybody happy with the result? Well, I won't say happy. Is everybody satisfied? Well, I wouldn't say satisfied. Is everybody keeping their rolls?
We've just rolled. Okay, we've rolled. Let's move on now to the bad news.
Keeping the rolls. Fia, once you feel the sound, you feel the sound, and you go to move your arms up, and then boom! After that, everything's ringing. And it will continue to ring.
I think my ears exploded.
Oh, she's got
for
10
minutes.
Oh my god!
You are
isn't
deaf
that
for
like 30 rounds or something? It's more
no.
than that. It's
it
like
20 rounds.
Oh my god!
I look at Zibble.
Great news is all you needed was a 10 to succeed.
What?
And that's when the large hornet ceases to move. And as you look up to see what the hell did that, covered.
Did it just pull a Night Fury move?
Oh, hang on. There we go. Covered in kind of this nasty hornet goop.
Ew.
A griffin.
Ew.
It kind of veers back around and lands in front of you all. And on its back is a shining knight in silver platinum armor with a hooked halberd that is covered in this hornet goop. And
silver's my color.
All the knight does is point at the other knights.
Is it Tom Cruise?
And makes a gesture like, come on. And the other knights immediately take formation. And this silver knight kind of looks back. Silver Knight looks back and gestures to you all. And then looks over, and you can only guess that they might be saying something. And one of these knights with the red cloaks looks back and says, if any of you are able and willing, we need to clear the streets. We have to kill this Tarrasque.
Shing. So oh, ready. Oh, for the Tarrasque? No, thanks.
And and the professor and the High Mage look back and go, but what about the university? And the red cape goes, there are far greater things to worry about than losing this university. And they take their formation and begin to charge. They don't take flight, they begin to charge down the street on the back of these griffins.
Oh, okay. I thought they were just going to fly off and leave us on the ground to deal with the stuff.
No, so they're going basically back where your French got crushed and killed.
Oh, Jesus.
Why do you have to bring us back to that sad place?
Is Fia still on the ground? Like, covering her ears, writhing in pain?
I'm making sure my ears are not bleeding.
She just sees all the stuff going on. Yeah, she's like...
Alright, well, I'm gonna go over to help, like, you know, we gotta go. Hold on to me, let's... Just follow me. Let's get out of here.
I'm not even gonna try to resist with that. I think he's helping me out, so.
Okay.
I can't hear anything.
Correct.
So.
I guess I'm going to trust, like, an authority figure, or what I perceive to be an authority figure, so.
Oh, your knowledge? My bad. Your knowledge. You know that is the knight captain of the Eldritch Guard.
Whoa.
That just busted up in here. If there is any militia authority around right now, it is 100% that person.
Yeah. All right, so that's, yeah.
They kind of like look back, and two of the red capes fall back. Like, not fall back, but they hold their position back and look to see if anybody's coming.
Can I kind of wave out to them saying, I pointed like three of us, oh no, four of us, boring, what about boring? Four of us were coming.
Everybody's going?
I'm not resisting anything because I don't know what the hell's going on.
Yeah, fantastic.
All I see is people pointing and trying to shout, and I can't read lips. I probably can, but I'm not even trying to right now.
Would you really, if you're able to read this one?
Yeah. So as they kind of hold position and see four of you running back, you don't hear this, but you hear the two of them shout forward, "Halt! We've got four!" And so all four of them stop, save for the night captain, who rushes around the corner. And for now, we're going to kind of move into abstract terrain.
Okay.
We won't be using full maps for a lot of this.
I've still got my sword drawn ready, just in case.
So, what we're going to do, copy this over, and we're going to go to this map for now.
So the best thing about being a mage is, at this level, I don't even have a weapon. I have a kitchen knife. That's it. It's not even a kitchen knife, it's like a letter opener.
They allow you to get on the back
nice.
Of the griffins with them.
Lumi's on its butt.
Give it a second.
Just the way I like it.
Are we actually flying this high? Like, that's how high above we are?
No.
Because that would be pretty awesome.
Yeah. No, I'm going to be using a generic token. I'm just kind of getting... Oops.
We could live on top of the pool.
I keep forgetting to move tokens to the front. I'll retry that. No point in putting the casters in the front there.
Yeah, please don't. Does this here get to ride with the night captain?
Nope. Nobody's riding with the night captain. Crazy.
I was about to say, he can have a romantic, like, Titanic moment where he's just holding on, hair blowing through the wind.
You want to feel like you're flying?
A whole new world!
It's like, I'm the king of the world!
Alright, so that's going to be you guys' basic formation there.
So, if Asir throws me on the back of this griffin with this other guy, I am so confused right now. And as soon as he takes off, I am clinging to this guy for my life.
Yeah, basically.
Well, before you go,
anything, so if he's telling me to stop or let go, I'm just clinging tighter. Because I think I'm falling.
Well, as we're flying, I look back to you and just give you a thumbs up. And like, it's okay.
So what's going on is that you guys are where that little happy face icon is. I'm using my happy face because it might make you guys feel better about things.
No, it doesn't. We're trying to take down a terrasque.
Actually, it just reminds me of shit, so.
I know.
And Merc.
So what's happening now is that you guys basically take off, take to the air, take to the skies. And that's when the true wake of devastation kind of sets in. You see this kind of rubbled path back here where the Tarrasque has come through.
I don't even know if I spelled Tarrasque right. Anyway.
No.
It doesn't matter. I don't need to spell it right. I'm terrified of it anyway.
Yeah, so there we go. Nice little rubble there. And it's just continuing its rampage through the city. And every jerk and movement takes you by surprise, Fia.
I'm clinging to this guy for dear life.
And?
Like, my legs are around this griffin so tight that I am not falling off. I'm telling you right now.
You guys kind of, you move out and you fly overhead the rubble spot where your friends died. And come up over this little quarter here. And you see probably half a dozen people dead in the street. And a displaced beast just kind of shifting back and forth, hunting and prowling around there. I'll give you guys a chance to say something.
What do we see shifting around?
That displacer beast that murdered the blacksmith.
Oh no!
Yeah, it's gotten at least 5 others. And it's shifting about down there in the street.
They can they just move kind of like interdimensionally.
Yeah, it's phase shifting.
Yeah, by the time you see its second form, it's too late.
It's kind of doing what Nightcrawler does from X-Men.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought.
But far worse because he's technically in both spots at that point in time.
Yeah. Like, the other side doesn't disappear until that one's moving.
I just think, like, as I'm looking down at it, like, I just get so nervous that my, like, crest pops out.
Well, all I do during this is I shift my eyes to try to get better perception.
Bori's furious.
In that case, can I look over to it and give it, like, some sort of gesture telling the... keep it in.
When you look over at Bori, you see her clinging onto the guy's cloak, almost like pulling him back, and she's standing up and looking down.
Bori is a badass bitch.
She's got one of her hammers ready, and she chucks it.
What?
What'd she hit?
Please tell me she hit something.
She crits.
Really?
She crit hits with a splicer beast. Bring up straw poll, guys. Give me a second.
Holy crap.
Bori! Oh my god! This furious little dwarven woman.
Bori!
Can I look over and go, what?
Aesir. Aesir, she's a keeper.
Yeah, I'm like,
you better make shifter dwarven babies.
Oh, and they'll be born with like hammers in their hands.
Just see it fly there.
Yeah. It goes slow mo as it crosses you and me.
I'm watching it like.
Oh, no, better still, does it boomerang, hit the displaced beast, then fly back into her
hand?
It
does a Captain America.
Man, I'm scared of her. So scared. Good thing she's on our side.
I can't wait to vote on the straw poll, guys. It's coming.
Yes. Is there like a small explosion from where it hit the displacer beast?
The blood splatter. Oh my god, these peanuts are so good. Look. They're ranch peanuts.
Never seen them before.
Oh my god, they're so good. They say limited edition, but they've been on sale for like a month. And my dad loves them. So my mom has been buying them in boxes. She came home with like 20 of them one time.
Oh my god. I think that's what I also do when I say it. I'll do my shopping there and bring it all back with me because I know it's going to last me a long time.
Alright.
Oh god.
I can't wait to see what the straw poll is.
Oh, there it is! Here, let me go to the other screen so we can all see.
Oh my god, these are all so cool.
For those of you that are watching on YouTube,
look at that jump!
Let me go ahead and read it. The options are Bori crit hits the displacer beast from the back of a griffin. And the chest. Pick one. The hammer splats into a tentacle and crushes it into the ground, pinning the beast there. The hammer hits with a loud crunch that deals extra damage to the displacer beast. The hammer hits with such force that the beast is stunned, and whoever decides to jump off and attack auto-succeeds the skill check to land, not the attack roll. Or the hammer hits as the beast shifts and gets stuck in temporary space, then it flings back out to where Bori can grab the hammer after hitting.
Man. Yeah, come on, that one has to win, guys.
Yep.
I go just a minute longer.
Far out. Certified badass.
Mm-hmm. The theme song for Bori is Badass Bitch.
Oh, man. I gotta ask her to teach me how to throw hammers.
Oh, she'll teach you how to work your hammer.
All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, boom. The result is that she sends the hammer flying down. It hits the displacer beast as it's shifting. Then you can kind of, from up there, hear as the displacer beast basically kind of gets stuck in between space, and then the hammer, you just hear ping, and it flies back up, and Bori just reaches out and grabs it. And the displacer beast is on the ground, just kind of like, kind of moving about, stunned and dizzy. Like, what happened? It took... eight damage from the attack. Oh, sorry, no, wow. Max, no, a little bit more. Sorry.
That's pretty good for level one.
1800 damage.
Took 13 damage. Sorry, I forgot to roll the crit damage.
Whoa! 13 damage. That is great for a level one.
Oh, all the while this is happening.
Oh my god.
Before she actually threw it, could I be like studying its shifting patterns to figure out how she did it?
Well, that's going through space. So that's not shifting like what you do.
No, like I mean shifting is teleporting, you know?
Oh, no. What happens is you see it, and then it's at both spots at the same time. Then it shows up solid at one of those two spots. Never really the same kind of pattern.
Oh, so
it's just really sporadic.
I'm going to go here or there.
Yeah, okay. It's in both, and then decides what's best afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
So it's if it was only a threat in one spot, then it would be in another spot, basically.
Could I also... Oh, did they have a maximum distance I could have learned from that?
No, not really.
Alright. OP.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's strong.
That's crazy. That's...
You do not fuck with displacer beasts.
No. The lesson you should be taking here is that you do not fuck with
Bori. With Bori.
You don't fuck with Bori.
That's a given.
Learned.
If you don't mess with the displacer beast, something that can hit it and deal crit damage to it is definite no.
And retrieve the weapon immediately. Off.
Yeah.
The Eldritch Knight kind of like leans forward and pulls Bori back off balance, like, pay attention.
Bitch, you don't get to tell her what to do.
And she kind of like... And she takes her hammer and just holds it and just, like, plops back down on the back of it. Just watching. She's kind of sitting side saddle, just watching this displacer beast below as it's starting to regain its senses.
Oh my god, I'm drawing this.
Yeah.
I love Bori.
This displacer beast are very much quantified.
You picked the right one to say it.
Just kidding.
Oh my god, don't do that! No one say your love for characters, okay? We don't want a Game of Thrones this.
The four knights are communicating and basically say that they have to get closer to this Tarrasque.
I hate Bori.
We're beginning to fly over Split Street and the Golden Mastiff.
Okay.
Can I yell it? Suck shit, Kev.
Let's see here.
We switched ownership, remember?
Yeah, we did.
He sold us out.
He sold it. And we were about to meet the new owner next day, guys. That was... Man, we were getting a pay raise.
Plot twist, Tarrasque is the new owner.
No.
This is what you see in Grinalda Square.
Oh my god!
God damn.
Is our bar there? Oh my god, it's Camden!
So,
what?
Utter devastation.
Tony, why do you have Merc there?
Huh? Oh, that's because I forgot it was there.
Give her a proper burial. That's his ghost wandering the streets.
I'm gonna go see Zabel play one last time.
His ghost walks the bar.
And you hear his voice just in the distance going, delicious.
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 At least I didn't give him something to say from beneath the rubble.
Oh no, oh my god.
Although the Terminator outro was pretty good.
Yeah. So, you continue to fly over, and it kind of like sets in that, you know, there goes the bar. And then they land in this square where you see at least another 13 to 15 Eldritch Knights. And with them, they have these glass vials that are kind of like this, and then they raise up to a very near funnel. And they're discussing something like, we have to use these, and the only way we can do it is from above. We've lost too much trying to use these from the ground level. We need somebody to fly over and drop these. By that point in time, you can hear now.
I can?
Yeah, you can. There, everything's kind of like starting to...
It's starting to slowly come back.
You hear this being said. And they look back at the new approaches, or the new people approaching, and they all give a low bow to the Knight Captain. And what ends up happening is the Knight Captain hops off the back of his griffin and begins to kind of inspect the area. And this place has just a small minor barrier kind of going around it. It's not one that you can really see on like the Dun of University one. This one kind of like makes it look like there's just a literal bubble around. It's almost like
it's a party bubble.
A kid blew a bubble and around the place. And... they all get this low bow and kind of begin to report to the Knight Captain. The next thing is that they go to inspect these large vials. And you see the Knight Captain give kind of a quick salute. And the four guys that were riding with you go over and grab two of these vials each. They seem to be pretty heavy. Some of them kind of struggle to hold them up. They walk over to you guys and say, hold one.
Okay.
But how will I hold on to you?
Yeah, so Zibble and Fia, I'll need you to make an athletics check. Bori says she'll hold both.
Bori, you're making me look weak.
Bori's like shorter than half your size, and she is like a beast. Okay, athletics check, you said?
Yeah, from you and somebody. don't waste a hero point on this. As you go to hold it, it just, like, almost pulls you down, and the knight in front of you has to, like, oh, gosh. And he, like, rushes and carries and says, well, then you have to drive.
Oh, no! Well, I got a better score in that than athletics, so maybe?
How's your animal handling?
I got a 2.
You got +2 in animal handling?
Yeah.
Does Zibble have an animal handling?
0.
We're in for some fun. So you have the option of using
Could I use my animal handling to guide the griffins with like hand signals? Since obviously I've been living out of the woods.
No. You get to hold the thing because you are strong enough to hold the thing. It's animal handling or sleight of hand? So, they swap positions with you, they hold these large vials, and the Knight Captain holds up their halberd and gives the signal to take off. You two need to roll your check to make these griffins take off.
I'm going to do sleight of hand.
Okay. Perfect.
Mm.
Oh,
hey, look at that! We mixed!
How did you do that? That's amazing!
Wow.
Besties!
Well then. That's pretty amazing, guys.
So, does she get a bonus for that? Does she have three points?
No. do you want to use anything before I reveal the results?
I think you should use a hero point. I think you should use a hero point.
Well, you have inspiration as
well.
We deserve
a hero point for that.
Oh, wait, you have 2 points of inspiration.
You have one inspiration.
One inspiration, so you can get that 20.
Yeah, you can.
Because inspiration uses your advantage roll.
Inspiration.
Okay, then I'll do that.
Okay, so great. All the griffins take off perfectly. You guys kind of stay in synchronization. And you begin to head towards the Tarrasque, which is just... There's nothing but smoke and rubble, and his back rears out, and he gives out a loud roar, which everybody has to make Constitution save for as you draw near.
A Constitution?
Yep.
Constitution. I want to call my griffin Striker Eureka.
Wait, we're all rolling Constitution again?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, okay. It's not that bad.
Oh, no.
Always.
Zibble's not going for the bonus stars at the end of the night, is she? But so far, she's getting it for the lowest total rolled.
Hey, leave Zibble alone, okay? She's probably still in shock.
This is what happens to me.
Yep.
I am the RNG bad luck.
So, you keeping it?
You can use a hero point. It might make it a 10.
If you don't roll a 1 like
I
did.
Can I ask you if that would be worth it if I used a hero point?
You're looking at being deafened for a bit. So,
I had.
All you have to do is look around and fly a griffin. So, probably not. I'd say saving that for flying the griffin's vastly more important than.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. I'll do that then.
So, as the roar kind of echoes out, it thunders against your ears, and you are deafened for 3 rounds. Whatever 3 times 6 is.
You can go into your cheat sheet, and it'll tell you exactly what deafened is.
Okay, I'm going to do that.
The griffins kind of screech out and begin to wobble a little bit at the roar. I need Zibble and Fia to make their piloting checks.
Okay. That was sleight of hand.
Is this okay? I'm on the right thing.
Ooh.
It's not that bad, yeah, I guess.
You managed to keep control of the ribbons. Mm. It's a little bit of a struggle, but you hold on. You hold the reins tight, and so does everybody else. As you fly closer, you begin to make a wide arc towards the back of the Tarrasque.
Oh, gosh.
Large claw comes up out of the rubble and goes straight for you guys. Give me yet another piloting check.
Oh
my god.
Okay. It's blasting out of the smoke and debris.
Oh, nice.
Oh,
we're doing it, Lumi! We're doing it! We're doing it!
Fia, would you like to keep that result?
Why do you have to scare me like that?
I feel like I, like, look over at Fia and I'm like, ah!
I can't really, like... I need to save my hero points for other things, like myself surviving.
Okay.
Don't look at me like that! You're making me so nervous!
Use your hero point! Just to make sure you use your hero point.
I'm gonna keep it.
Okay. You barely managed to pull the griffin back, and it's a harsh pull. It's sudden and fast.
Oh god. That guy behind me better hold on.
As you move forward and try and steady the griffin out, you look back, because you felt him lose his grip from around your waist. He's still there.
Okay.
And you look down, and you realize both his hands are around your waist. And there's a cacophonous...
I prematurely erupted, guys. I'm sorry.
As the vial fell from his hands trying to hold on.
No! Oh,
and
no.
He's just like, what the hell were you thinking? And he clambers around and pushes you behind him. And he says, just hold on!
Okay! I'll do that!
I'm a leaf on the wind.
So the thing, like, it exploded. Do we see that?
You see, like, there's black smoke rising from.
If anything, it might have distracted the Tarrasque.
Tarrasque doesn't seem to care as it continues to wander forward. Yeah. Continue to add to destruction here.
I hope 6 miles is enough.
Six?
No, we're down to 3 now, 2, 4, 6. Aren't we?
No, 2, 4, 6.
Mm-hmm. Each person has 2.
No. Each person has 1. What are you talking about?
Yeah, that's each person
has
1.
And Bori has 2.
Okay, yep. So 5.
Yeah. So down to 5. Because you guys had to hold them. No, you're right. It was 2-piece. My bad. My bad math there. That is 2, 4, 6 left, yeah. Apparently, Erstatz was unhappy with
Trent is not impressed.
I missed it, so... Oh, no.
So I am actually carrying 2 potions, like, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I don't know what the reference was, because I think that's when I accidentally tabbed out.
Serenity. Firefly.
You have gotten towards the back of the Tarrasque.
Whoa!
Ah!
What? No, thank
and
you.
The night captain holds her spear up high, and that signals for you guys to drop.
Are you serious?
Serious? Drop. I hate carrying these things.
I need a.
Oh, you meant drop the vials.
Yeah. Ranged attack.
I don't have to do anything.
Can my attack hit?
Yeah, you have to make a ranged attack.
I was about to say, can I fling a spell at it? But I don't have components.
No, what you do for ranged attack, you go into core stats.
Okay.
And it's essentially, you make a dexterity save.
Okay. Alright, dexterity save.
Hero point. I'm gonna use another hero point.
Okay.
I think I'm gonna keep 15.
Yes.
Okay.
You know, so that's 2 15s.
Mm-mm.
It's 2 15s. The bombs fall below. Large explosions sound off. And large hole, 2 very large holes open up where the 4 bombs fell from you guys. And there's one further ahead.
Nice.
Very nice. We pierced it.
Man. Our bombs will be the ones that pierce the heavens.
2.
Yeah.
Oops.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah, it goes. 2 hit in 1 spot there. You gotta resize.
Okay.
It won't let me resize. Yay. Whatever. 1 up there. That's supposed to be a larger one. Anyways, they open up. And immediately from your left flank, you see a couple of griffins ride by and lightning arc into the thing, and there's another loud roar. Constitution saves.
Okay. Yep, yeah. Here we go. Oh, no!
I'm going to use my... I don't mind being deafened.
Do I just get deafened again? Like... Mm. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, my ears were shifted and everything
Everybody
when I heard that.
Is deafened for 2 rounds, so 12 seconds as your griffins circle back. The night captain holds the halberd up high, points down, and the other griffins descend, Zibble needs to pilot the Griffin. Fia, you don't have to. You're just...
Okay.
I'm holding on for dear life.
Sleight of hand. Can I use one of my hero points for that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so roll. Is that D6?
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic.
Higher than a 10.
All of them descend in unison, and the night captain jumps off.
Onto the Tarrasque?
Onto the Tarrasque.
What?
That person has some balls. Oops.
Could me and Boreosa jump off onto the Tarrasque?
Yeah, just and stop
stabbing holes.
Need to add the tokens here. I mean, make them that big, jeez. There we go. I'm trying to get everybody's tokens real fast. And the other knight over with Bori jumps off, and Bori goes with him.
Bori goes with the night captain?
Yep, and their griffin kind of like flies off and joins the other pack that had just gone by. Hey, Siri, you said you wanted to jump off as well.
Mm-hmm.
Zibble, the knight in front of you says you should join him and just jumps off. Or behind you, sorry. And Fia, like you didn't hear him, sorry. He just jumps off, basically. He looks back at you and jumps off. And you see the other people were jumping off. And then Fia, the knight that was piloting you, does just about the same thing, and it leaves you to grasp if you're trying to hold on. I have one more knight here. There we go.
I do not want to get on the back of this thing.
You could just fly around, be air support or something.
I can't do anything.
can you do swooping attacks with the griffin?
Totally try to. Gotta take, if you're staying on a griffin, I need a piloting roll.
Alright, I'm gonna try.
Is it, boy, are you staying on or hopping off?
I'm hopping off. At this point, I feel like I'll be a better use with everyone else.
The most I can do, guys, is make a campfire on the back of this thing.
That no, thing about that, no, that would be cool. Like you could pour.
She's on there.
Let's roast the marshmallows, guys. So come on.
What you can do is you could pour the alcohol that you took from it into one of these wounds, and the Tarrasque can light it on fire.
Yeah. Well, I can Burning Hands it.
Feel the burn!
Well, do the other griffins go back automatically? Like, are they returning
to... Yeah, they're joining that other pack that came up the left-hand side.
Oh, God. Oh, my God, this is a really hard decision, but I'm going with what Fia would do, and she's going to try to grab the reins.
Okay.
Oh, okay. That no red worries. Border scared
Unfortunately,
me.
Unfortunately, you had disadvantage because it was...
No!
That guy's magical s'mores. Beautiful. All right. You are support griffin.
Support griffin. I'm just shouting, you guys can do it!
Welcome to being...
a level one sorcerer. Died.
But Falstaff's not.
You can do flybys.
Yeah, I can try to do flyby Burning Hands.
Oops.
If only someone else could start a fire.
Yeah.
All right.
That would fit.
I'm staying behind the Tarrasque, but not within tail range. So I'm on its flank.
Those of you that are on his back, make an athletics check or a acrobatics check.
One don't let it turn okay. around to me.
Because it's...
Alright, here we go.
Nice.
Oh, ooh, snap. Very nice.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to actually, this is the party's turn. And then the Tarrasque acts at a mystery initiative. Asir, you have the highest dex, so you roll for the party.
Did I just roll dex?
Initiative.
Yeah. Oh, whoops.
There you go. Just give me God's hammer. I'll make up for it. Can you toss this? Hold it just like that.
What are you doing?
I'm eating, because I'm hungry, because I'm freaking out.
As you're flying by.
Yeah. Fia, I need some of your cream pies.
Anyways, Night Captain stabs the Howard down, and you see this, you hear a short burst of thunder and look back to her or him, and freaking lightning arcs all around the Night Captain. And there's a loud roar that comes from the Tarrasque, but it's aimed forward, so you guys kind of like clasp your ears that can hear. You don't have to worry about it. You're kind of getting used to this roar now. The others follow suit and jab their halberds into these open areas under the scales and arc lightning into them. So the three of you guys' turn is now.
I don't know, I'm just going to stab my sword right into it as well, even though I know it's not going to do much.
You're like screaming as
blink,
they are.
Blink, blink, blink.
All right, make an attack roll.
Oh, sorry.
I'm hoping I might hit a nerve or an artery, a very, very, very major artery.
It like splurts and shoots you off. All right. So you hit for 10 damage, you kind of just like twist in under the scales as the Tarrasque is reeling.
Can I make a suggestion to Bori?
Yeah, what would you like, Bori?
Hammer the sword in further.
She comes and she runs like up the back of this large carapace, jumps, and goes to hammer with both hammers, just kind of like lining up so one's going to hit and the other's going to hit behind it.
Is she using, like, one hammer as a nail and the other hammer as a hammer?
No, she's using his sword as the nail and both hammers as a hammer. Both make their connection. She just kind of... And, like, as she does that, she shouts really loudly. She's, like, fully raging right now. And the sword goes in under the scale and actually goes under the scale. Like, you manage to hold
like
onto it.
Like, the hilt goes in?
Yeah, like, she hammers it so hard that, yeah, it goes straight to the hilt and then some.
Nice.
And she ends up dealing...
Hilt deep.
Yeah, hopefully there's an organ under there.
Hilt deep.
15 damage.
Whoa.
Yeah, 15 damage with both of those.
Shit.
And, she pulls the hammers back. And looks over to you and just basically says, what next? Zibble or Fia?
I have an idea.
Is there anything that we can find out about, like, how much, like, right now we just have the first layer of flesh exposed, right? Like, this underneath, it has, like, a carapace type of
Yeah, you're
shell.
On the carapace. Yeah.
And is there, like... Is the skin, like, directly underneath it? Like, we could reach out and touch it, or...?
Yeah, you got the scales, and, like, if you were to peel up the scale enough, if you could, if you're strong enough, you could probably expose some straight-up flesh.
Okay.
And that's what me and Bori just pierced.
Let me see what...
Pussy wagon was
no, Pussy Wagon was the best.
We had some good times on the Pussy Wagon.
Some good times on the Pussy Wagon. I do. I like the tokens.
Oh man, I love Boris token. Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm trying to think about like what I want to do. But
okay, well then
let me get Shine knows what she wants to do. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so this is a really stupid idea. But whenever the Griffin makes another like a fly around thing, I guess. Well no but...
You mean when you pilot it around?
Yeah.
Okay. You gotta make the pilot check as your move action.
Okay, will I still be able to do my action?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So, if it gets, like, around, if I go, like, this way, I want to come around here.
You mean you just want to go back over there? You remember, you're the one that's piloting this thing right now.
Yeah.
So you want to move over there?
Right. Oh, I can move it? I didn't know.
No, you can't move it. I'll move it for you, though. That's where you want to go?
Yeah, that's where I want to go.
Okay.
And I can try, I'm gonna need to make another check, I know it, but whenever it's doing, like, it's straight way, the Griffin, can I try to do a Burning Hands this way?
Yeah, over what's the range of Burning Hands?
It's a 15-foot cone in front of me.
Okay.
But I need to do this.
Okay, give me a concentration check. Oh,
wait, before you do that, could I actually get Fear to do it onto the sword and heat up my sword to melt through even further?
It'll hit you guys.
Yeah, it's a cone. And she's basically
like running. I can't choose who it
and
hits.
And she's like flamethrowing her arms and trying to hold
it. Oh, a flamethrower, okay.
Yeah. Now, this does not need a concentration check, but you want me to make one?
It's either that or I'm going to have you make a dex save.
How do I make a concentration check? How do I make one?
Oh, concentration is you would roll plus your spell bonus, whatever you use for that, which is your charisma bonus, plus you basically just make a charisma save because you're getting your
charisma save.
Yeah.
Okay. I still don't want to botch this. Ooh, I crit on that one.
You can't crit on skills. But why the hell not? I'll make a straw poll.
I'm happy.
Straw poll.
We'll just call this a crit.
You're basically mini Death Star laser this thing and it just blows off.
I did a what's that thing? The thing that in Dragon Ball Z shoot fire out of my face.
Oh, that thing, yeah. The nail gun, whatever it was called.
Yeah.
I'm so excited to see what this straw poll is.
Worst thing, gets a really, really bad sunburn.
Yeah. We started at level zero, right?
Mm-hmm. The first session is actually in our YouTube channel. I don't know if that's linked anywhere on the Twitch thing. But if anyone has the link, feel free to link it. No, you haven't missed much. Basically, what happened is we were living our lives as level zeros. We went to school, worked at a bar, stuff like that. And then one day, this mist came into town, and this portal opened, and this Tarrasque just popped through, and people died, and people cried. We cried. I cried after.
So much crying.
So much crying. Ugly crying. And
I'm crying in my soul.
Yeah.
He cried before everything happened, because some...
Really yeah.
Alright, it's up.
I have dreams, you know. I just want to one of the piece of Kelly's ass.
Yeah. All right.
Excuse me. Actually, all he wanted was just a piece of ass. So.
We all dreams.
On the back of the Griffin.
We all have dreams.
It hits the Griffin.
No, and then the Griffin's came along. You're on the back.
I just want a piece of their ass. You feel me?
Yeah.
Like, you're on the back of a griffin, no big deal. Like, that's what I'm describing.
But it leaves a smoldering splotch on the back of the griffin.
On the back of the griffin?
Yeah. You put that, it burns my griffin.
No, not... Okay, guys, it doesn't...
Off the back of the griffin, comma, that burns for...
Okay. Oh my gosh, I... wild magic, oh my god, I'm voting. Look at that! I need to be turned into a potted plant on the back of this griffin.
No, you turn the Tarrasque into a potted plant.
Mm-hmm. That'd be the best thing about this is,
everyone,
guys.
Alright. Landslide on magic. Wild magic.
So. I do not roll this. Vex rolls it. And no, I don't
I roll it and then what I have is a massive table of results, thanks to Don John. And what's going to happen is, let's see here.
I want the one where I can't speak for 5 minutes. Everything just comes out as bubbles. Or I want the magic missile as a level 5 spell.
Counters.
I want that one. Or a fireball.
Wild magic.
I'll be happy with a fireball.
What happens is I generate 10 of them, and then she rolls a 1d10. Roll me a 1d10.
Oh, God.
One.
At least I get my one out.
Squeezed one out.
Squeezed one out.
As you kind of recover and look back, roll a damage for your burning hands.
Okay. So I just do this thing. There you go.
So 10 fire damage. It can crit, so roll me another damage just to be safe.
Okay.
Good job. So 24 freaking fire damage. And as you kind of steady back out of nowhere, a red and blue parrot lands on your shoulder and goes, and it's swearing at the Tarrasque.
Oh my god! A parrot?
A parrot. And you guys kind of like, you hear this? You hear this and you look up and she does. She just has this parrot on her shoulder.
You know what? I'm just going to do this because I would need to. Because I'm that scared the shit out of me.
A swearing parrot. Out of nowhere.
Now, would the parrot swearing demoralize the Tarrasque?
I know, right? You can hear it.
It does psychic damage.
Fuck you!
What? Yeah. Probably kill a bitch!
Pirate pyromancer now!
Yeah, really. I had to move these out a little.
It should be a little there. Phoenix. I just can't do anything but swear at people. Still better than Jem. For those that don't know, Jem was our son Conyer, and she would scream at the top of her lungs.
That's all I should have done. Just...
I think that's more insulting.
Specifically lands in the kaiju's ear. Alright. So.
Brilliant.
The Tarrasque at this sudden onslaught of damage kind of buckles for a second and then rears back.
Oh god.
Everybody athletics.
Do I have to make an animal check?
No. Actually you do because you're right there. Yeah.
Would I get advantage since I'm still holding onto my sword?
Can I do acrobatic?
No.
Check.
Grab Bori! Save her again!
Bori's got like gravity boots. She's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. So I have to do athletics?
Yes.
There athletics, you go. Yeah.
So if Bori does start slipping, I can also grab onto her.
Yes.
Whoa.
Nice. All you guys are awesome.
Everybody holds on like a badass, but...
Can I grab onto his cape? If Bori's fine.
I was about to say, you got a choice, him or Bori.
Oh god.
Bori.
There is no second thought on that one. Wait, can I fly and catch him?
Quick, do the Wilhelm scream. Do the Wilhelm scream.
Oh, I could pick one. Whichever one. They both look the same to me.
Can you
grab
one?
Can each of us try to grab one?
As this one falls past you, you can try and grab that one. And give me an animal handling to try and catch him.
How do I...
Instead, the griffin falls.
No! I'm riding the griffin and it just goes...
He reaches out and tries to get a hold of the griffin's paws.
I'm visibly falls. Trying to reach for him. I'm trying.
He smacks the back of the carapace and stops screaming. Falls lifelessly to the ground.
Oh.
Zibel.
Does that mean I get to keep the griffin?
Yes.
Just asking.
Like right before he goes unconscious. I got dibs on this, right?